Jesteśmy na drugim dniu konferencji Konopie w teorii i praktyce we Wrocławiu. To międzynarodowa konferencja, na której występują prelegenci nie tylko z Polski, ale także z zagranicy. Mamy przyjemność porozmawiać z Markiem i Jody Emery.
The first thing that was necessary was to empower the people who already agree with us, our people, the cannabis people. So teaching them how to be capitalist, start businesses, sell seeds, make bongs, to finance conferences, rallies, and political activity. All these things require money. So it was necessary to teach our people how to earn money, raise money, and spend this money in a useful way to spread our ideas.
So education is the most important thing just for the beginning, yeah?
Well, education is the most important thing, but to educate people you need resources, finances, and so it was important to encourage everyone to go into some kind of business, make bongs, grow marijuana, sell seeds, open a shop, get into the medical marijuana business, this sort of thing, because once people had a job and money, they could do much more in helping, and that was important.
Yeah, it sounds nice, but how was the attitude of the government in Canada while you started making such things, such events? Were they for it or against?
Oh, they were always against it, and they arrested me many times. Five raids, they took $1 million worth of my assets over five raids. I was extradited to the United States and served 5 years because both Canada government and the American government were very upset with me and very angry. But this tended to help because it created more publicity and more media and allowed me to speak on many, many opportunities about why we should not punish peaceful, honest lifestyle choices, and that is what cannabis is, a peaceful, honest lifestyle choice. It's mostly just being perseverant and patient. It's taken 25 years, but now we see these results. Well, there are many people who are suffering, and they should be made most prominent. People in wheelchairs, people who have disorders where they are clearly suffering, people who have cancer and their hair is gone because they have chemotherapy. Politicians and media and citizens, they do not want to contradict people who are suffering. And so I would say you must put the suffering people in the front lines of the battle. And they want to be in the front lines because they are upset and they are hurting and they are angry that politicians will tell them that they cannot use marijuana for medication. This makes them very angry, so they are excellent people to put in the forefront. You want to avoid the young people with smoking, having a party and a good time. This is not helpful. So the best thing is always have the medical people who are suffering do the television, the radio, and in the media.
Okay, and I got one question for you, Jody, because while you speak, in one time you said something which could be very important for Polish people, for Poland now, because you said don't legalize yet, maybe just depenalize.
And well, legalization should also include decriminalization. So if something is legalized, it means you are not criminalized to possess it or use it. But for many people, they're not comfortable with full legalization yet. It seems like marijuana will be everywhere and they don't want that. So decriminalization, they can agree with. They can say, okay, patients should have legal marijuana, and decriminalization where the consumer is not arrested, that's good too. But that's only one step. After decriminalization, we need legalization.
Because you also switched to the topic that marijuana is not only a treatment for illnesses, but it also helps people to prevent illness.
There is a lot of research showing that cannabis use can prevent Alzheimer's, and it can help you just stay relaxed and calm. While Mark was in prison, it was very difficult, and I consumed cannabis as a therapeutic medicine so that I wouldn't be so stressed all the time. So it's definitely more of a natural healthcare supplement for many people, where it's just like eating a vegetarian diet. They feel better because they use it that way.
Let me add one thing too. My father, he died of a stroke, and he was paralyzed, and his father died of a stroke, and his father. So these things are genetic. I will probably get a stroke. My mother died of Alzheimer's disease. Both of these illnesses can be prevented by the use of cannabis. And by the, in the same way too, because when the THC is going through your blood, it breaks down plaque. And this is the plaque that causes strokes, aneurysms, and that kind of fatal illness. And it also breaks down the plaque that causes Alzheimer's disease. So I do not say I use it medically, I say I use it therapeutically because I want to live longer. I'm living longer, and maybe only 3 or 4 more years longer, because smoking cannabis does not make you immortal, but it will help me live longer by breaking down the plaque that causes Alzheimer's and plaque. Yes.
Okay, and the last question. Because you said that you are planning to make some tour across USA to educate people to travel through a country, and what would you say to make something like here, maybe one time in the future in Poland like this?
I'm sorry, can you ask this question? Okay, go ahead.
We were talking about a cross Canada tour because Mark is well known and he hasn't been seen so much since coming back. And we have the groups like the government and different mental health and addictions experts. They're holding information sessions in small cities saying, we're going to legalize marijuana, let's talk about it. But those people come from a bad prohibition bias. So I feel we need marijuana experts and advocates to also hold meetings, education meetings. Because even though Canada is going to legalize and we have a lot of positive things happening, it's still very hard for patients to find marijuana in small towns. Doctors don't sign paperwork for many people. And businesses are being closed all the time. So we need to still go across Canada and educate in the small towns, because sometimes you get caught up in the excitement of the big cities and it's okay and easy to get, but most of the country still struggles.
Okay, so generally it seems that there is a lot of work in front of us, but everything is moving in the right direction. I hope so. Yeah.
That is the most important thing, the direction. We are moving in a positive direction. It never happens as quickly as we would like. But for example, I have found the booths and the sponsors and the people who are producing material here very sophisticated. As sophisticated as in the West. So what there is here today is much like what was in Vancouver 5-10 years ago. It is not that far behind. I think there's a book called The Tipping Point, and I think Poland is closer to this tipping point than we think. We are, when you are activists, you are always inclined to think that the problems will persist for a long time. I do not believe that. I think Poland will see legal marijuana and medical marijuana within 5 years. I think much of Europe will, and because it is this wave of information that is going around the Euro, as social media, and also how rapidly things are translated now from one language to another. And also, this is very sophisticated. This, and the CBD people upstairs, all this is very sophisticated. So it shows a much more advanced state than I think people who are in this environment think.
Okay, so thank you very much for those optimistic words, and I hope they will...
It's going to be great.
Yeah.
It's going to be great.
Thank you very much.
People will suffer in the short term, but it's going to be really wonderful in 5-7 years.